For as long as we've had valuable things, we've needed ways to keep them safe. Vaults, state-of-the-art security systems, wooden chests buried in hard-to-find places. But if your idea of a pirate bay is more website than desert island, and your valuables are data rather than doubloons, you might prefer a more 21st century solution, blockchain. This cutting-edge idea is essentially just a form of record-keeping. Think a spreadsheet with some extra features. Okay, doesn't sound thrilling. But in many ways you've heard about, and maybe some you haven't, lots of people think blockchain is going to change the world. So it's worth knowing what it is and how it works. Let's say I make some new friends at my local pizzeria. They're a lovely bunch, but not very trusting for some reason, and they tend to get into arguments about who paid for whose calzone. We could just track this in a spreadsheet, but to keep the peace, let's make use of the extra security provided by blockchain. When we meet on Monday, we write down who buys what for who, and at the end of the day, we feed that data into a cryptographic program called a hashing algorithm. This does some stupendously complicated maths with it, then spits out a unique 64-character code, which we hang on to. On Tuesday, we do the same again, but this time, we include Monday's code along with Tuesday's data. The algorithm generates another code, which we include with Wednesday's data, and so on, creating a series of blocks of data, each chained to the last. Now, a few key things to mention about this process. First, each block's 64-character code, its hash, represents exactly what we fed into the algorithm. If even a single digit of our records were different, the hash would be too. Secondly, blockchain is append-only. Unlike a spreadsheet, where you can go back and change entries whenever, in a blockchain, once a block has been validated, hashed, and added to the chain, it can never be removed or altered. Thirdly, everyone involved gets a copy of the data and the hashes, because blockchain is a decentralized system. Normally, sensitive information like your bank balance is held by a central authority, which is trusted to ensure only the right people get access. But in a blockchain, this isn't the case. Here, everyone adds to the same record, and everyone gets a copy. Now you may be wondering how everyone having access to everything can possibly be secure. Well, imagine one of my friends adjusts his copy of Monday's block to say I owe him 5 large margaritas. Sneaky. But he's got a couple of problems. The first is blockchain's decentralization. Everyone has a copy of Monday's block. So if only one is different, it might be obvious why. On top of that, remember how each hash exactly represents the data in its block? This means as soon as that data changes, the hash changes, and will no longer match the ones stored in the next block. Busted. So, editing old records is a non-starter. But what's to stop our mischievous marauder tweaking the numbers before the block is validated? The answer is consensus protocols. Systems which make sure that everyone A, agrees the data in a block is legitimate before it gets validated, and B, has an incentive to stay honest. There are a lot of these, but the most common is proof of work. Remember the stupendously complex maths our hashing algorithm was doing earlier? Well, in proof of work, that process becomes a competition. Lots of users running the same algorithm racing to finish first. There's a twist though. To keep it from being too easy, the hash has to meet some conditions, starting with 10 zeros, say. That added difficulty takes a lot of power, energy, and money, making cheating much less profitable. And profit is the operative word, because this is where cryptocurrency comes in. In systems like Bitcoin, whoever wins this race validates the block and is rewarded with some private currency. For the sake of this example, let's call ours iluli coin. With each block we add, more iluli coins come into circulation, a process called mining. And anyone who wants to join in can. Recording data in blocks, mining new iluli coins by hashing and adding blocks to the chain, paying each other, and maybe one day our favorite restaurants in iluli coin. Sounds great. Except that running loads of computers to do arbitrarily complex maths is a bit like revving a car just to prove you can burn fuel. Wasteful and bad for the environment. That's why many cryptocurrencies are aiming to switch to proof of stake, which requires much less computing power, meaning a much smaller carbon footprint. Like proof of work, users who validate blocks are still rewarded with cryptocurrency. But rather than competing to solve maths problems, here they enter a sort of lottery, buying tickets by staking currency. The larger their stake, the greater their chance of being selected to validate blocks. Although this does mean that those with lots of currency are likely to keep winning more of it. If the data in any block they validate turns out to be faulty, they lose their stake, providing the incentive to play nice. There are loads of potential applications for blockchain technology. Ratifying business contracts, tracking votes to prevent election fraud, even preserving evidence of human rights abuses. But as worthwhile as those are, the most famous blockchain use cases remain cryptocurrencies. And the story behind the most famous of these, Bitcoin, is one worth telling. It's a tale of drama, intrigue, global economic disruption, and more pizza. Join me next time to hear it.